So, welcome everybody to today's coffee lecture on the topic of reusing data from the research collection. My name is Barbara Hirschmann. I'm the head of e-publishing at ETH Library. The goal for today's coffee lecture is that you understand under which conditions data from the research collection can be reused, and that you can discover different methods for retrieving bibliographic data and usage data from the research collection repository. We are going to look at under which conditions to reuse content, including publications and data, abstracts and metadata from the research collection, how to download metadata via the user interface, or how to retrieve it by using our APIs, and last but not least, also how to access usage statistics from the research collection. As you probably know, the research collection is the repository of ETH Zurich. It contains bibliographic data on publications that were produced at ETH. It contains open access publications and also research data from members of ETH Zurich. The content in the research collection can have different access modes. So not everything that is published in the research collection is open access. There are also publications or data that are still under embargo. For research data, there are other access modes, such as access for ETH members only or for selected users only. And there are also some publications and data in the research collection that are not available online, for example, doctoral theses that cannot yet be made open access. This is just an example of a so-called closed access publication. So this is just to describe what kind of access modes you can find with publications in the repository. But today we are going to focus on the open access publications and data and how to reuse this content from the research collection. Basically, legally, when you use content from the research collection, the terms of use of the repository apply. You can find them in the footer of the website. And there is one section that's called access and reuse. And that is the relevant section for reading up on the terms for how to reuse content from the research collection. Now, if you look at an example of an open access publications, the section here within the metadata that you have to look at is called rights/license. In this section, you will find the rights status of this publication or under which license it is published. Very common is this very short statement, which says it's in copyright and non-commercial use is permitted. This is the standard license, rights statement under which a publication in the research collection is usually deposited if there is no Creative Commons license. And it means, and I'm citing here a paragraph from the terms of use, that you can download this publication and save it on your device for your own private use or for non-commercial purposes. So that's basically what you can do with an object that has this in copyright statement. It means that the copyright is with the author or creator of this content. If you want to do anything else, apart from downloading it for private or non-commercial purposes, you have to ask the permission of the copyright holder. Now, if you find a data set or a publication that has in the section a Creative Commons license, it gets a lot easier to reuse this work because the Creative Commons licenses allow a lot more than the normal copyright statement for finding out what exactly the conditions of this Creative Commons license are. You just have to follow the link to the license. Here we have, for example, a Creative Commons Attribution Non-Commercial No Derivatives license, and there is a small, a short summary of what this means, but there is also the complete license text that you can read up and see what can I do with this work. One important point is that usually with Creative Commons licenses, you are allowed to redistribute the work. So you can publish it again under certain conditions if you need to do that or want to do that. Then when it comes to abstracts, you might find a publication where you again see this right statement, and then usually it means that the reuse conditions for this abstract are the same as for the full text. So if you have already seen that there is a full text and the rights condition says that it is in copyright, then you can assume that the same applies to the abstract. But I wanted to draw your attention to the fact that there are also items in the research collection which only have an abstract, such as this one on the right side. And in this case, you will not find the rights statement here because this is a metadata only item. And in these cases, be very careful because the abstracts may only be used for personal use and nothing else. So while the reuse options for abstract might be very, very limited if it's a metadata only item, on the other hand, the reuse options for metadata from the research collection are very open. All the metadata from the research collection are available under a so-called public domain dedication, which means that you can use it, modify it, and redistribute it without asking ETH for permission or even attributing this to ETH Zurich. But please be aware, metadata does not include abstracts. It only includes other fields like author, title, and so on. So now how can you get these abstracts? This metadata. First of all, we recommend that when you want to download a certain list of publications, use the expert search terms. There is a description in our manual which explains how to use the expert search in the research collection search field. For example, here we have a search for a certain organizational code and a certain publication type. And if you need lists of less than 500 items, you can just download them via the export option. If you need export of metadata that includes more than 500 items, you can either separate your search requests into smaller result sets, or you can also contact us via this email address because our staff at ETH Library has admin rights in the research collection. We can also download larger result sets for you and send them to you via email. Of course, if you are familiar with using APIs, it might be much easier to access certain publication lists or subsets of items from the research collection, not via the user interface, but via our APIs. We have an so-called OAI PMH interface, which can be used, for example, for integrating research collection items into other search engines. It's used for incremental harvesting of publications, and it delivers different standardized metadata formats, such as, for example, Dublin Core or DataCite. And you can also use it to retrieve different subsets of items, for example, only items with full text or only certain publication types. This is a publicly accessible API, and there is also a public documentation in our manual. The other API that we offer is a REST API. This is an API that you can use for automated searches or for generating publication lists. For example, if you are at ETH and have your own website, group website that is not already in the ETH content management system, but in a separate one, then you could build an integration with the research collection by using this API. This is that metadata is delivered in our internal format that is based on Dublin Core, but also contains certain fields that we have defined internally. And you can filter your results by different criteria. If you are a member of ETH and you want to access this API, please contact us and we will deliver you the documentation. Then I wanted to draw your attention to the fact that we also have usage statistics on the published documents in the research collection. You maybe know them because you can access them for each individual item on the items landing page. But it's also possible for our staff to retrieve exports for download counts and page views for a certain list of items. For example, if you want to know the download numbers of all publications from a certain group, we can generate such a list with this information that contains this information. So please contact us if you would like to have these download counts for your group, for example. So to sum up, there are a lot of public information, but there are also things that we can help you with. Please contact us at the research collection if you need batch export for results lists with more than 500 items or batch export of usage statistics or any other research collection related support requests. I also wanted to draw your attention to the fact that we have a specialized support service for bibliometrics at the library. My colleagues from this group can help you with impact analysis for the publications from your group. They also generate bibliometric profiles and reports and give individual advice on the topic of bibliometrics. And since sometimes we are asked how the data from the research collection could be reused for text and data mining purposes, I also wanted to mention that we also have licensed content that can be used for text and data mining projects at the library. And please contact my colleagues from the e-resources department if you are interested in that. Thank you very much for your attention. This was the last copy lecture of this series. I hope you will join us again next spring. And if you have any questions, please just unmute yourself or write them into the chat. In the meantime, I will share a short survey for you, which you can use to give us your feedback on this coffee lecture.